We now introduce you to the teaching ministry of Pastor Joseph Kansima. Pastor Kansima is a man of God who teaches the Word of God in simplicity but with great impact.
Your nearness to where revelations are does not mean you will obviously or automatically get the revelation. Attending a church where a man of God or woman of God preaches powerful revelations does not mean you will automatically get them. Proximity does not bring revelations in our lives. Two things I have said so far. Natural intelligence does not bring revelations. Proximity does not bring revelation. Number two, longevity. Being long in the things of God. In fact, some of the blank people I see when it comes to revelations are people who talk about the history of when they were born again. I was born again in 1992, born again in 2000, what? Born again in 81, 83, and in those days, they are talking about those days. But when you check from those days, the only revelation they have received is salvation. Because even salvation is revelation. It is God revealing himself to us. It is the Holy Spirit revealing Jesus to us. You and me cannot be born again without the revelation of Jesus being the Son of God. That's why there are many, many people who have heard the word preached. Many, many people who have watched men and women preach, both in church, on TV, but never get born again because they have not received the revelation. And so, friends, it is very possible that in 1981, when you got born again, you received the revelation of salvation. You ended there. So today is 2021. All this year, you have not added any revelation on the revelation of salvation. In other words, it has been so many years, but spiritually speaking, you are still, or I am still on level one. That's how this thing works. And so, it is not enough to say, I've been a Christian for the past 30 years, for the past 40 years. The question is, along the journey of all these years, how many revelations do you have? How many revelations have you received? Because it is only in those areas where you and me have received revelations that we are going to experience victory. Those are the areas where we're going to experience spiritual growth. It works like that. And I'm telling you, it's that way. You can be a man of God like me and yet blank. You can preach, I can preach for many years, but there are areas of my life where I don't have revelations. And those are areas of shadows, areas of darkness, where the enemy will steal from you and me. So it must be understood that we don't receive revelations from God because of our intelligence, because of our the proximity that we have. You can have the Bible very close to you, no revelation. Read books, no revelation. You can also be long in the church, but you only have level one revelation, that is being born again. Okay, so having said that, let me say now, how do you receive revelations? How do you reach a point where you begin to get revelations from God? You begin to be a man whose eyes are open. Your spiritual things are becoming live to you. You can see where others cannot see. You can perceive where others can perceive. You can read the Bible, and as you read the Bible, it is like the world has opened to you. It is no longer just logos. It becomes a personal rhema word. How do you do that? Go to the book of Matthew chapter 11. Matthew chapter 11. We're talking about revelations, how to receive revelations for changing levels. Revelations for changing levels. It's not how long you have been in church. In fact, friends, people have been in the church for a long time without revelations are very argumentative. They annoy because they will argue on logos. They will argue, they will criticize preachers on logos because they have not walked in the revelations that they are supposed to. They criticize young believers and so forth. Now, how do you receive? We go to Matthew chapter 11, verse 25. We read that verse. The Bible says, at that time, Jesus answered and said, I thank thee, O Father, the Lord of heaven and earth, because thou hast hid these things from the wise and prudent and hast revealed unto them to babies. Babies. Come on, say babies. Okay? Number one, in receiving revelations, it is humility and teachability. Is to have a humble spirit and be teachable. The babies here, it is not saying small children. It is a symbol of men and women who are humble, who are teachable like children. It's not talking about hot and high-minded pride men and women. No. And it's not saying babies, symbolizing small children. It is talking that, Lord, you have hid these things to people who thought they are intelligent people, high-minded, the prudent, but you have revealed them to those who have come to you in humility and the teachable spirit like babies. That's the first thing you need to know. The first thing you need to know is to reach a point where you say, I don't know, I need to know. I know a little bit, I need to know more. And whenever we reach a point where we are too much of ourselves, it becomes very difficult even to read a book of another man of God. It becomes very difficult for you and me to go in the bookshop, especially we preachers, and go and buy books written by another man of God. It becomes very difficult to go and buy a CD of another man of God. Listen to it with a humility heart until the end. Some of us will just listen to it, jump it, and say, I know all about this. You'll be shocked that you thought you know and yet you don't know. This week, I was just praying and waiting upon the Lord. One man of God made a statement on faith, and I realized I thought I knew this. I realized I did not know. I did not know. But you see, I listened to that message, I think about 3-4 times. I'm listening. And he made a statement that it just came as a revelation. And I'm not going to tell you now. I'll tell you another time. So the first thing, if you want to move from levels where you are to another level through revelations, it is you and me having a spirit of humility. The teachable spirit. Many years ago, I wrote a book. And after I wrote a book, I went to one guy, he's a pastor. And I told him, man, I wrote a book, and I would love you to market it for me in your church. He looked at me and said, you know what? Me, I don't believe in reading other people's revelations. I said, oh. He said, I just read the Bible. I said, okay. And he said that. And I looked at him. I pitied him. It's not because he can't read other people's books. He's just proud. There's no humility. In other words, he was telling me, who are you to let me read your book? I'm a man of God. I know what I'm doing. Okay. And I left him. To cut the story short, about 2-3 years, he came to me. He traveled from the nation where he is to come to South Africa. He came with a book and said, Pastor, help me to publish this book. I looked at him and said, okay, so Others can read your book. It simply means you don't believe that it is wrong to read another man's book. You only don't believe that for you, because you are this great man of God, you can't read another man's book. Pride, humility, and simplicity, teachability can usher you into revelations. I can ask you a question. The year has become. How much have you planned to go and listen to other preachers? Many years ago, I think I said this one time, somebody came and talked to me about one man of God. He went to be with the Lord. His name was Bishop Matthews Chikwanda. How this guy was rocking the copper belt of Zambia by the message of faith, or with the message of faith. He talked to me that this guy, when he's preaching, you sense God. And I was in a town called Chama. Chama. Chama is on earth. And this guy was said to be coming to a town called Chipata in Zambia. For those who are in Zambia, you know those towns. And I planned to go and attend his conference. The leaders of the ministry where I was, they never allowed us to interact with other ministries. If you did that, you are a rebel. So, but I heard so much about this man. I told myself that though they don't want me to go and hear this man who preaches faith, I need to know about faith. I am going to go there. And what I'll do, because I can't go and sleep in the houses of the brothers, they will know I'm here. I'll be sleeping at the bus station and go to hear him preach, come back and sleep at the bus station. If they find me, I'm saying I'm on my way somewhere. And I did. I went to the town. That was about 2 hours of traveling on a gravel road, most part of it. And I arrived, reached at the bus station, went to the meeting where the meeting was supposed to be. Unfortunately, the man did not come. Having the humility, the simplicity to learn from others. If you open your heart, you open your mind to sit down. Some of us, friends, cannot listen for 1 hour. We are jittering up and down. In such a situation, you cannot and I cannot receive revelations. Revelations are given to the babies, the intelligent, and the prudent miss it. Number two, how to receive revelations from God. Number two, expose yourself to the word of God and the teachings that are revelatory. Expose yourself to the word of God and to the teachings that are revelatory. What do I mean? The first thing is to expose yourself to the Bible, because you and me cannot receive the Rhema word without logos. We cannot receive the Rhema word without logos. So the first thing you do is to expose yourself to this word. Take time to read the Bible. Even if you don't receive any revelation, just start reading it and reading it. By doing that, you exposing yourself to logos. It is out of logos that you shall receive Rhema. The Rhema word is what we call the revelation, personal revelation. And I said revelatory teaching. Revelatory teachings are preachers that when they are teaching, they can open your eyes to things that you don't know. I'm talking about preachers who preach what we call the principles of the Bible. I can encourage you not to spend too much time with motivational speaker preachers. You don't need a preacher all the time for motivation. They are out there, people who are not even born again, who are expert and excellent motivational speakers. And so when we come to church on the pulpit, personally, I believe, is not a place of motivation. It's a place of revelation. It's a place of opening people's understanding of the Word of God. It's a place where we let people say, oh, I did not know that. God has just opened my mind. And many born-again Christians don't understand that. Expose yourself to revelatory preachers, even if you don't like them. If they carry revelations that you need, put yourself in the place where you can receive from them.